Good morning, dear children. Welcome to our English class. Hope all of you have enjoyed the Onam festival safely. We have already learned lesson 3 talk. Now look at page number 21, exercises. A. Who said this to whom? What has been done for you? Number 1. Well, at last you are here. You never waited me, but now you have come around with your digging stick. Go away and leave me alone. The yam said these words to a countryman who was a farmer. Who said this to whom? These are the words of the yam. These are the words of the yam. The yam said these words to the farmer. Now look at second sentence. Man, put me down softly. These are the words of the palm tree branch, and it said to the farmer. So we can write this as the palm tree branch said these words to the farmer. Now look at third sentence. Is that all? Is that so frightening? Whose words are these? These are the words of the fisherman. So we can write this as the fisherman said these words to the farmer. Now look at fourth sentence. Where are you going in such a rush? Whose words are these? These are the words of the weaver. The weaver said these words to the farmer and the fisherman. Now look at fifth sentence. Now this is really a wild story. Whose words are these? These are the words of the village chief. So we can write this as the village chief said these words to the farmer, the fisherman, the weaver, and the man who was bathing in the river. Now look at sixth sentence. Fantastic, isn't it? Imagine a talking yam. These are the words of the stool, chief's stool. So we can write this sentence as the stool said these words to the village chief. Now look at page number 22 in your textbook. Vocabulary. Fill in the blanks choosing the correct words given in the help box. Which are the words given there? Fragrance, courtesy, expensive, bought, chandelier. These are the words given in the help box. What do you mean by fragrance? Fragrance means a pleasant smell, sugandham. Courtesy means a respectful act, bahumanikiga. Expensive means high in price, amidamaya vila. Barred means preventing entry, nirodhikiga. Chandelier means branched lighting fixture, bahushakha deepam. Pala ശാഖകളുള്ള ദീപങ്ങളുടെ ഒരു കൂട്ടം, അതിനെയാണ് ചാൻഡ്ലിയർ എന്ന് പറയുന്നത്. നൗ ലുക്ക് അറ്റ് ദ സെൻറ്റൻസസ്. ഫസ്റ്റ് സെൻറ്റൻസ്. ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് കോമൺ ഡാഷ് ടു വിഷ് സമ്മൺ വെൻ യു മീറ്റ് ദം. വിച്ച് വേർഡ് വി യൂസ് ഹിയർ? കോട്സി. ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് കോമൺ കോട്സി ടു വിഷ് സമ്മൺ വെൻ യു മീറ്റ് ദം. ലുക്ക് അറ്റ് സെക്കൻഡ് സെൻറ്റൻസ്. ദ സൂ അതോറിറ്റീസ് ഹാവ് ഡാഷ് ദ എൻട്രി ടു ദ അക്വേറിയം ദീസ് ഡേയ്സ് ആസ് സം റിപ്പയേഴ്സ് ആർ ഗോയിങ് ഓൺ. ഹിയർ വിച്ച് വേർഡ് ഈസ് കറക്റ്റ് ഹിയർ? ബാർഡ്. സോ ദ സെൻറ്റൻസ് ഈസ് ചേഞ്ച്ഡ് ടു ദ സൂ അതോറിറ്റീസ് ഹാവ് ബാർഡ് ദ എൻട്രി ടു ദ അക്വേറിയം ദീസ് ഡേയ്സ് ആസ് സം റിപ്പയേഴ്സ് ആർ ഗോയിങ് ഓൺ. ലുക്ക് അറ്റ് തേർഡ് സെൻറ്റൻസ്. ഐ ലവ് ദ ഡാഷ് ഓഫ് റോസസ്. I love the fragrance of roses. Now fourth sentence. When all the bulbs were lit, the dash looked magnificent. When all the bulbs were lit, the dash looked magnificent. Which word is correct here? Chandelier. When all the bulbs were lit, the chandelier looked magnificent. Now look at fifth sentence. He brought an dash gift for his friend. Here which word is correct? Expensive. He brought an expensive gift for his friend. Now look at language and grammar. A. Rewrite these sentences using the correct words which give a feeling of fright and horror. You have already learned that a noun is a naming word and an adjective is a word that describes noun. Noun ennu paranjal ഒരു പേരിനെ സൂചിപ്പിക്കുന്ന വേർഡാണ്. അഡ്ജക്റ്റീവ് എന്നാൽ നൗണിനെ ഡിസ്ക്രൈബ് ചെയ്യുന്ന, നൗണിനെ വിശേഷിപ്പിക്കുന്ന വാക്കുകളെയാണ് അഡ്ജക്റ്റീവ്സ് എന്ന് പറയുന്നത്. ഹിയർ ടു വേർഡ്സ് ആർ ഗിവൺ ഇൻ ബ്രാക്കറ്റ്സ്. വി യൂസ് ബോത്ത് വേർഡ് ആസ് അഡ്ജക്റ്റീവ്. But we should remember that here we use the adjective which gave a feeling of fright and horror. അതായത് രണ്ട് വാക്കുകൾ ബ്രാക്കറ്റിൽ കൊടുത്തിട്ടുണ്ട്. രണ്ട് വാക്കുകളും നമുക്ക് അഡ്ജക്റ്റീവായിട്ട് ഉപയോഗിക്കാം. പക്ഷേ നമ്മൾ ചൂസ് ചെയ്യേണ്ട ഏതാണ്? ഭയത്തെ സൂചിപ്പിക്കുന്ന രീതിയിൽ വരുന്ന അഡ്ജക്റ്റീവ് ആയിരിക്കണം നമ്മൾ ഉപയോഗിക്കേണ്ടത്. നൗ ലുക്ക് അറ്റ് ഫസ്റ്റ് സെൻറ്റൻസ്. ദ ഡാഷ് ഫാർമർ ബിഗാൻ ടു റൺ. ഹിയർ ടു വേർഡ്സ് ആർ ഗിവൺ ഇൻ ബ്രാക്കറ്റ്, ഫ്രൈറ്റൻഡ് ഓർ ഓൾഡ്. വിച്ച് വേർഡ് ഗീവ്സ് ദ ഫീലിംഗ് ഓഫ് ഫ്രൈറ്റ് ആൻഡ് ഹൊറർ? ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് ഫ്രൈറ്റൻഡ്. സോ വി യൂസ് ദ അഡ്ജക്റ്റീവ് ഫ്രൈറ്റൻഡ്. The frightened farmer began to run. Look at second sentence. A dash scream was suddenly heard in the darkness. The words given in brackets are loud and blood curdling. Which word gives feeling of fright and horror? That is blood curdling. So we can use the adjective blood curdling. The sentence is changed to A blood curdling scream was suddenly heard in the darkness. Now look at third sentence. He saw a dash thing near the water. The words given in brackets are short or weird. Which word give feeling of fright and horror? That is weird. So the sentence is changed to He saw a weird thing near the water. Look at fourth sentence. He was too dash to move. The words given in brackets are warm or terrified. Which word give a feeling of fright and horror? That is terrified. So the sentence is changed to He was too terrified to move. Look at fifth sentence. Cold dash ran down his spine. The words given in brackets are feelings or shivers or water. Three words are given there. So the word which give fright and horror is shivers. So the sentence is changed to cold shivers ran down his spine. Look at sixth sentence. He could see two dash eyes looking at him. Here also three words are given in bracket. Big, glaring, round. Which word give a feeling of fright and horror? That is glaring. So the sentence is changed to He could see two glaring eyes looking at him. Look at seventh sentence. He was dash and began to run once more. Here two words are given in bracket, that is alarmed or ashamed. Here the word which give a feeling of fright and horror is alarmed. So the sentence is changed to He was alarmed and began to run once more. So dear children, that's the end of today's class. You should complete page number 21 and 22 in your textbook. And in your rough book, you should write 5 places that are silent and 5 places that are noisy. For example, a library is a silent place, but a market is a noisy place. Thank you everyone. See you in the next class.